packing up camp. So we're meeting another 79 down here today. Shane Only Touring on Instagram. Go follow him. He's the one I learn all my little tricks off for the car. So he'd be a good one to follow. And Rob. Robbo's Full Dryer 4x4 Adventures. We're meeting them at the top of Mintbush, which is like this little valley just here, which you probably can't see. You see the power lines? That's Mintbush just there. So we just got to get back up out to the road and just meet them at the top. Mentioned be there in 10 minutes. It'll take us 5, not even 2. But yeah, this camp spot, unreal. Great little spot. It's just, there's been a lot of grubs here. So whoever's been camping here, you should give yourself a good uppercut. Chair. There's goon sacks, cooking trays, meat trays, cans everywhere. There's egg cartons, glass everywhere. There's some shit over there. Absolute joke. Absolute flogs they are. I'd be going back.
Yeah, I'd try going backwards and it got worse, eh?
Might just have to pull you back a little bit.
Yeah.
Better if I go forward, rear, and try and reverse it in. Well, I'll just, if you just jump on here like this, I'll drive forward.
Go jump down in this car. Slight lack of concentration a little bit there. And just dipped her into a decent hole and lifted a bit of that wheel. So we'll get our way down here and keep on going. This is only the start of Mintbush too, we got all day. One boggy hole. We took the right hand turn down towards the flex track just to see how well our bricks operated through this little section here. It's a pretty easy little pinch.
and then it takes you back onto Mint Bush so you can keep on heading down towards Monkey Gun. Shane's cruiser here, dropping his 37s down below the door seals pretty easily. Finished messing around on the flex track, jump back on Mint Bush Fire Trail, making our way down to Monkey Gum. This is one of the many creek crossings you'll come across when you're on your way down. This right here is one of the other creek crossings. This is, I believe, the last one before you hit Monkey Gum. It's now starting to turn into a mini sort of version of Gunshot. It's not as deep and big of a drop down. It is nice and boggy on the bottom. And those shorter wheelbases, as you can see with Rob's here, he just got a little stuck. His lockers weren't working as well. And because of his wheelbase, he couldn't nudge forward just enough.
Oh, no.
Gotta let this tire all the way down, clean a bit of the mud. I've got a little bit of it in the bead just here. That is the start of Monkey Gum. It's challenging in the wet because a lot of double steps here. There's two rocks back down there that lean right out and it spits you towards it, just panel damage. But we got up there, bit of rock packing, all right.
Just got to continue up from here. This is sort of the rock garden. It becomes the beginning of it. Shane was saying, he goes, you wouldn't even be able to tell the old track from the new one now. Last time he done it, it was about 2 years ago. So you'll see this little crossover section here. You probably would have been able just to drive straight up through it once upon a time. Thank you.
this section here we all decided to opt for right on the wall. We went up on the high line, it actually leaned pretty far into that bank. It's a bit of off camber. It may not seem like it, but it's not the greatest feeling, especially in a cruiser. They're top end heavy as it is.
I was looking at it a minute ago and said you would be able to do it.
Nice.
It was a good drive. Low and just slow, controlled.
What happened here, Rob? What have you done?
Done myself a mischief.
A bit of a mischief.
On yet, so brand newies.
Yeah, so they're brand newies, so I'm hoping that.
And they're not hard to carry too.
No, it's only light.
Yeah, easy to fit.
So we're just about to do the final sort of section of Monkey Gum. And Rob's done a tie rod end. Snapped a tie rod end, luckily it was on the flat, and then we've just got my baby cruiser here parked up next to Shane's big cruiser on the big 37s. Funny enough, they're both running the same suspension setup, or same but different shocks and arms and whatnot. But the start of the climb, there's a very, very big boy line over here. I don't know if I'm I don't think I'm that much of a big boy, to be honest. We'll just take the generic route. There we go, guys. Last little pinch of monkey gum done. Footage might not be amazing, but I'm going back down now. I'll follow Shane up, and then I'll also follow Rob up. Traction's pretty good. It was a bit wet this morning on Mintbush, and we all thought we were gonna be in trouble. Pretty good time, not bad. It's about 3 o'clock. I think we started at about 12 with the breakage as well. So 3 hours ain't bad. Yep, you just gotta watch that rear is gonna slide on that rock behind you. Yep, I just gave it a small little bump. The old monkey gum staircase yet again. And that's the end to another good wheeling. Another good day out on the tracks, driving. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment. Let me know how you feel about them. Let me know if you're enjoying these videos, and if you are, keep bringing them out.